All right, guys, this is Jitin here from Highlevel Techie, and today I'm going to show you how you can connect your Highlevel account inside your n8n using oAuth. Okay, so in the previous video, you saw how you can connect n8n using private integration key, but today we are going to do something different. So first thing first, you go into your n8n account and create a new workflow, and then you click on here or right click to add a node. And then search for Highlevel. Then you can find the Highlevel node. And then let's select something like creator update contact. So we have created the Highlevel node. You can see this is a Highlevel node. And if you double click on this, it opens up the settings for that specific node. And then inside here, you can see credential to connect with. I already have connected to one account, but I'll show you how you can connect to another account. Okay, so click here and then click on create a new credential. So this will open up a window like this, and you can see there is an oAuth redirect URL provided to you by n8n. So you can see here, all you have to do is click to copy this, because we need this URL in a minute. And the next one is authorization URL, which is white label URL, and client ID, client secret, and scope. So now what we need is the client ID and client secret and the scopes. And to find client ID and client secret, what we need is GoHighLevel Marketplace. So go to marketplace.gohighlevel.com, and you will find a, once you create an account, you will find a page like this, and then you go to app dashboard. In this app dashboard, you can create a new app. So click on create an app and give this app a new name. So whatever you want to call, like let me call it GHL connection app, and select the app type to be private. We are not building a public app which anyone can use. If you want to build a public app, it has to go through a review process and such. So we are not discussing about public app as of now. So select private for now, and distribution type, select agency and sub account, because if you want to make changes in agency and sub account, you need these two selected. So once that is done, white label is already pre-selected for you. It is recommended, so we are not changing anything. And then click to create app. So now the app is kind of created. The name is here. And you can see here app logo is necessary, even though we won't be using it for any other purpose. Highlevel is now asking for app logo as well. So you just need to find a square image that fits the image guidelines. So I'm just gonna select some random image now. So I have selected my image, and then the category, you can select anything, but doesn't matter. So I'm just gonna select other, and tagline. This is also doesn't matter. All of this come into play if you're building a public facing app, but since we are building a private app, this doesn't matter. So let's say test tagline, and the business niche, it's an optional field, company optional field. So everything else is optional, so just click save. And now you can see there's an error. The app name contains Highlevel reference. Please remove any Highlevel reference to save. So if you are building a public app, Highlevel doesn't want any Highlevel reference in the public name. So that's why it's not saving. So let's just say test connection app. So if you are building a public app, just keep that in mind. And now just click save again. And you can see it is saved. So as you save it, now it doesn't go to the next page. You have to click on listing configuration, and then it'll take you to the next page where you can see the settings that we have already selected. So all these steps are pricing and modules and such. These are all for the public facing app. We don't really need all these things. So we are going into advanced settings now and click on oAuth. So this is where we select the scopes, we set up the redirect URL, and we generate a client key, okay? So let's first select the scopes, yeah? So when you click here, you can see a bunch of scopes here. Depending on your use case, you can select any scopes that you want. If you want to create or edit contact, you search for contact, and then you select contact read-only, contact write, okay? So that helps your app to make changes to contact. You can read contact data, and you can also update contacts using these scopes. Now, there are certain minimum scopes that we require to connect n8n with GHL. So if you go back to our n8n workflow, you will see here the scopes that are required: location read-only, contacts read-only, opportunities and users read-only. So these are the things that we need. So just copy that and then come back here and search for those things. So first we need locations read-only. So let's find that out. Locations read-only, we selected that. Next one we need is contacts read-only, which we already have. Contacts write, we already have. Now opportunities read-only, opportunities write, and user read-only. These are the things that we need further. So let's do that now. Opportunities read-only, opportunities write. Now users read-only. I think we have all the scopes that we require to make this work, because you can see here scopes needed for node are these, and we have successfully selected those things. So now what we need is to set the redirect URL. And where do you get the redirect URL? You go back to n8n again and then copy this oAuth redirect URL, click to copy, and then go back and you paste that in here and then click on add. So that will add your URL here. You can see the added redirect URL is here, and all you have to do is you select this. So before you can select this, you have to save this. So now let's go here and click to save this. Now that's been saved, and then you can now select it, right? So now once you have selected that, what we now need is the client keys. In order to create a client key, all you have to do is click here to add and give this key a name. So let's say test connection client key and click add. So this will give you the key that you see here. So once you close this window, you cannot access this key anymore. So just make sure that you copy this key in a safe, secure place. So what I'm going to do now is going to copy this client ID and client secret and paste that into n8n. And now I want to add the scope. So all you have to do is just copy the whole thing here and paste that in. So the only requirement you have is these two scopes should be separated by a space, which is what exactly you receive when you copy and paste it here. So if you want more scope, you can add more scope into your app as well as here. But these are the minimum number of scopes that are required for this connection to be successful. So once you have that, all you have to do is click on Connect My Account. This would open up a window like this. And in this window, what you have to do is click here to log in. And this would open up your browser and you can log in to your agency account if you are already logged in through that browser. And when you go back to that same window, you can see the app installation confirmation is here. You can see the name of the app, the tagline of the app, the logo of the app, and all the scopes you have set for that app. Okay. And now all you have to do is click next. And from here, you can select your agency account or your sub account, which you want to connect to this particular n8n instance. So if you're looking to connect a specific sub account, you just search for that sub account. So I have a demo account here, so I can select that demo account and then select that, and you can see connection is now successful. And this window will close after 5 seconds. And if you go back to your n8n, you will see that account is now connected. So that's all you need to do. And now if you close this window, and if you see here, the credential to connect with is called Highlevel Account 2. If you want to change the name, click here and go here and change that to sub account name so that you know which account you're connected to this particular Highlevel, and click save. And then you can use any of the operations that are available under these predefined operations that you have. So if you go back And if I add a new high-level node, I can use create, update contact, delete contact, or any of these nodes that are available out of the box. I can use that without any problem. You can see I have access to contact records, I have access to opportunities and some tasks and calendar. So if I want to create an opportunity, I click here and it opens up, and then I can select my connection. So I have two connections now, and this is the latest connection I created, and this connects to this particular sub account. I select that, and this opportunity will get created under that sub account. So this is how you can connect to your high level using oAuth inside n8n. If you want to understand how you can connect using API version 2 and private integration key, you can check out my previous video. So now if you have any questions concerning how to connect your GoHighLevel inside your n8n using oAuth, please let me know. I hope this is helpful. I'll see you in the next one. Until then, bye.